We're in the village of San Ignacio, just a short ride away from Krill. And today's video, guys, we're gonna explore this area around here. I'm gonna introduce you guys to the Raromari people. These are indigenous people here in this part of Mexico, in Chihuahua, that, well, they've been living here for quite some time, man. Well, we're gonna show you their lives over here today. We're gonna explore it and see how it is. They live a very simple and traditional life right here in this valley. Cuida. Check it out. This is a cave over here of San Ignacio. And well, this is kind of how they used to live back in the day. Some of the Raromari people, they still live this way. And here, well, since we're so close to the town, it's a bit on the touristic side. They pretty much live off of all the handmade things here. Todas estas cosas son hechas a mano. Sí. Por ustedes, ¿no? All right, we're definitely gonna buy some souvenirs here. But basically, guys, we're very high up in elevation. I mean, some 2,500 meters. So in the winter time, it gets really, really, really cold over here. Minus 5, minus 12. The 1600s, when the Spanish colonists arrived here, the people here, the indigenous people, they don't want to change their ways. They don't want anything Western. They don't want to be colonized. So they got deeper into the canyon and, well, they pretty much live off their land 100%. Growing stuff. They just consume what they have. They trade with their neighbors. And that's pretty much their life over here. And well, since we're pretty close to Krill, there's some of them that, well, you know, they have all these handmade goods. And it's kind of to support themselves a little bit, but.
And they're collecting the grains here, the corns, and what kind of.
Oh, yeah, here's all their grains, beans, and a lot of corn. And this altitude, this elevation with the climate here, it's mainly beans and corn and potatoes. When it rains, they collect some of the water here, and well, they basically use it for whatever needs they have around the place, whether to wash something or anything that they need. This is how they'll collect the water. It'll come down from the rocks up there and they collect it just like that. This part right here, this is the kitchen area. That's why you can see it's more blacked out than the rest of the cave. That's where they do their cooking. Now these rocks over here are volcanic rocks pretty much, so they're very good at capturing the heat. And you can see it begins to get darker here in this area because this is where they will sleep. And where they sleep, they make more fires, and well, basically the rock gets darker after that. ¿Este es de usted?
Sí.
¿Este cuánto es?
20.
20 pesos. Okay. Aquí está. Lo demás para usted. Muchas gracias. All right. Now we have to pay this with the other girl.
¿Cuánto es para todo, por favor?
100. 100. Aquí está. Está bien así. Muchas gracias. All right, let's go. Explore around the village a little bit. This part of the field here, the people would normally plant corn, and during this time it will begin to grow more, but this year they didn't grow anything because they thought the rains weren't gonna come, so they only planted potatoes and beans on the other side. This right here is one of the tools that they use to cultivate the land. They'll tie this up to a horse and it'll make the rows, and it'll do what it needs to do to the soil so that they can plant their food. Plant their seasonal crops. Everything goes by season here. Check out some of these goods over here, guys. This right here is to keep your tortillas nice and warm. And as you can see, these artesanales are very, very simple and basic. They are made with everything around the area. Pretty much nothing is imported. It's just what they have here. This right here will be a bag. But it's a bag kind of like in the shape of, not in the shape, but these are the traditional clothes of the women over here. You can see here's a little mini bag there. It's pretty nice. And then this over here, this is catching my attention. Cuira, amiga, buenas. Esto, ¿cómo se llama?
Canasticas.
¿Y más o menos cuánto tiempo se tarda para hacer una?
Un día
para hacer una de estas. Y es hecha con pinos, ¿no? Pinos de acá de la zona. Smells like pines from the area, guys. Let's open it up. Oh. So basically, look, you get little canasticas, mini versions all over, all sizes. Oh, that's the last one. ¿Y cuánto cuesta? 20 pesos. 20 pesos, guys, that's a dollar USD for a full day's work of putting this together. Yeah, aquí está. Toma. Muchas gracias. Alright. I'm gonna keep this for my travels. I'll see what I store in it. As you can see, all across the valley, you have one home there, you'll have another one there. And well, this is one of the bigger communities that we're gonna find. But normally, the Jajamaris, they like to live separated. They believe in diseases of the soul. Basically, envy, jealousy, and things like that. So to avoid all that, they prefer to live far. Here, this being one of the biggest communities of them. We can see some of the homes here are a lot closer than usual. And well, this right here will be the typical home that you'll see around the valley. And it's pretty much made all out of rock, as you can see. A metallic roof there, a little bit of progression, we can say. Put some rocks on top to keep it in place. But pretty much if we get deeper into the valley, it'll just be made out of rocks and wood, basically 100% living off the land. These rock formations over here, you can get pretty creative. Cooking something here. I'm not going over there, buddy, don't worry. I come in peace. But check it out, you have some really spiky cactus over here. It looks like somebody, one of the locals, has discovered beer here. Now, the women, they pretty much just live off of what they grow or what they make, their handmade things in this area. And the men, they grow stuff. They work the land. And in this area here, some of the men have been working in plantations farther off. They get picked up. And what happens there is that they get mixed with Mexicans, or we can say mestizos from other parts of Mexico, just like me and you. And they bring in, what can we say is the word, their costumbres, pretty much maybe drinking some beer or whatever they're into. They might introduce that to one of the workers and then they might bring that here into the village or something like that, and it can be quite unfortunate. So that's why you can see one of the reasons that they're not very fond of us, the chivochos here, because they see what our costumbres have done to some of their members. Now and in the past, this dates back to the 16th century when the Spanish invaders came over here and tried to take over. It was at that point that they immediately wanted none of it and they fled deep here into the Copper Canyon. And well, I guess this will be a bathroom over there. But have a look, you see the ladies here walking around. It looks like they're selling some of their goods over there. Few homes scattered around. Cura, ¿cómo se llaman ustedes?
Yo me llamo Raúl.
Raúl. ¿Y tú?
José.
José. ¿Y sus nombres en la lengua de ustedes es lo mismo o?
No, estamos diferentes.
¿Cómo sería en su lengua?
No, nosotros somos la alta.
La alta.
¿Qué somos?
Sí, es igual. ¿Igual?
Se dice igual, nombre.
Ok. ¿Y de aquí, tradicionalmente, de qué viven ustedes?
Un poquito pobre vivimos aquí nosotros.
¿De la siembra o otros trabajitos que le salen por ahí?
No, trabajamos también.
Ok, y ¿sería posible escuchar algo en su lengua? La jaramari, si pueden hablar algo y decir algunas palabras. Por ejemplo, decir, hola, ¿cómo estás? Mi nombre es Carlos.
Kira.
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 ¿Cómo te
llamas?
¿Cómo te llamas? ¿Es cómo?
Churuemu.
Churuemu. Mi nombre es Carlos. Churuemu. ¿Y cómo se dice para decirle a mi esposa ahora, te ves muy bonita, te ves muy linda? ¿Cómo digo eso?
Arachima.
¿Bawachima?
Arachima.
Tarachima. Ok. Bueno, ¿lo dije bien o no? ¿Tarachima?
Sí, ya
era. Hola. Entonces, esa es su casita acá, ¿no? Y la construyen típicamente, las casas de ustedes son hechas de piedra y madera.
No, estas son de adobe.
Este es de adobe, de la piedra de acá local.
De pura tierra.
Pura tierra.
Es como, hecha como ladrillos.
Como ladrillos. Le dicen acá adobe.
Adobe.
Ah, está bien. ¿Y esta es tu casa acá?
Sí.
Ah, está bien. Y típicamente un día típico para ti viviendo acá, ¿cómo es? ¿Qué haces tú todos los días? Pues te despiertas o...
No, hacemos artesanías.
¿Artesanías?
Sí, artesanías.
Luego trabajo también.
Aquí. Trabajo, acá.
Un poquito trabajo de todo.
Estamos pobres nosotros ahorita, por lo pronto.
Sí, porque no vinieron las lluvias este año.
Porque casi no llovió.
No llovió, entonces muy poca sembra.
A veces vamos a trabajar en la manzana también, a Cuauhtémoc.
¿La manzana?
Sí.
Ah, ok, ese es el pueblo allá y trabajan con las manzanas allá.
O sea, salimos a Cuauhtémoc a trabajar también.
Ok, un poquito de todo. ¿Y la gente de Jaramari que vive más profundo en el valle, ellos de qué trabajan o no trabajan?
Pues sí, unos pocos también. Aquí queda también vendiendo también unos pocos.
Y para los que viven bien profundo allá en el valle, viven de la tierra nada más, solo siembran y...
Siembran y luego también ellos vienen a vender aquí.
O también hacen las artesanías y las venden acá.
Esos traen sus burros.
Ok, se ven en embujos desde lo profundo en el valle. Y todavía hay algunos que viven en las cuevas, ¿no?
Sí, hay unos. Acá al lado hay una cueva, aquel lado más.
Sí.
Acá están dos cuevas, ¿no? Acá tenemos otro cueva, ¿no? Por el lado.
Y la gente todavía, algunos viven ahí en las cuevas.
Sí, bueno, está bien.
¿Y qué dirías tú que es lo más importante de la cultura de los Jaramaris? ¿Qué es lo más importante para ustedes?
Pues es lo que es, la siembra ya, pues, ¿no?
La siembra.
Luego las artesanías, lo que hacen todos.
Las artesanías. Pero aquí viven una vida bien tranquila, ¿no? Más que todo tratan, si sería posible, trabajar con la naturaleza. La siembra, las cosechas y... Está bien, bueno, muchas gracias por su tiempo. ¿Les puedo dar algo para ayudarlos como puedo?
Sí, cómo no.
Sí, cómo no. Let's get these guys a boost, guys. ¿Ustedes viven juntos acá o...?
No, aparte.
Ah, bueno, si pueden, se dividen estos 500 pesos ahí para ustedes dos.
Claro,
que los ayude como pueda, pues,
no,
y que vengan más lluvias, pues. Ahí estamos. Hasta luego, pues. ¿Cómo se dice chao en su idioma? Hasta luego, bye.
Chirihueraba.
Chirihueraba.
Gracias.
Ok, no. Hasta luego, chirihueraba.
¿Ustedes se entienden en español?
Sí, español sí. Pero jaramari no.
¿Jaramari?
No sé. ¿Y tú sí? ¿Qué me puedes decir?
Ella le puede cantar en tarahumara.
¿Ah, sí?
Vamos a ver, vamos a irla a cantar, pues.
Una canción.
Una canción.
Sí. Uh-huh.
Significa que mi abuelita subió para el cielo, pero que ella me sigue queriendo desde arriba, desde el cielo, y que ella se llama Teresa.
Muy hermosa tu muy canción. Hermosa, sí. Y tú cantas muy bien también.
Gracias, sí. ¿No quieres que le tome la foto?
¿Una foto? ¿De qué nos vas a tomar una foto?
Pipila.
¿Ah?
Pipila.
¿Nos vas a tomar una foto tú?
Con ese, con la cámara.
Con el celular, para ver. Bueno. Aquí está.
A ver, venga.
All right, let's see. She's gonna take a photo of us. ¿Dónde? ¿Aquí? ¿Con el pie aquí así?
Ajá.
Okay.
El otro más atrás.
Y el otro más atrás, así. Ajá.
No nos lo va a esconder. Este.
Ajá.
Lecciones.
Ajá.
La mano la va a esconder y esta la va a poner.
La mano aquí así.
Y
escondo esto.
Esta la va a poner.
¿Estoy bien? All right. Para ver cómo quedó. Oh, wow. Wow, muy bien. Have a look at that. Eres una fotógrafa nata tú. Wow. Vamos a ver, vamos a darle su propina por la foto. Me gustó mucho la foto.
Gracias.
Este, aquí tienes.
Hola. Gracias. Muchas
gracias a ti, mi vida. A ti que te vamos a comprar, vamos a ver qué tienes. ¿Qué tienes tú acá para ver?
Guárdalo porque no vas a
perder. Para ver.
Sí.
Y tu ropa, esta es típica, ¿no?
Sí.
¿La podemos ver? ¿Y los guaraches? Y son hechos a manos esos.
Estos.
Sí, la ropa sí. Ok, para ver, ¿qué,
una cuchara?
¿Qué tenemos acá?
Bueno.
A made spoon. Well, I want to talk to you guys about this over here. This is made out of pine. But it's a specific palm that they use that grows deep in the valley, about, I don't know, some 4 or 5 hours. Esto viene de bien lejos, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Como unas 5 horas adentro del valle o más. 5 horas para conseguir esta palma, ¿verdad?
It's a bit too big for me to travel with, so I need something smaller, but...
This is one of a kind here. Oh, this, oh heck yeah, I want this. Este funciona para lanzar piedras. ¿Y cuánto es?
50.
50 pesos.
¿Y la cuchara?
32 por 50.
Okay.
Okay, you want the spoon?
Yeah, I will take that for my,
I'll take the slingshot. I'll take the slingshot and we'll give her 100 pesos too. Tome, igual que el de los nuevos. Muchas gracias, pues. Que tengas un buen día. Here's some drum, guys. They're also used as seats. And over here, well, they'll store water in there.
You know, when it doesn't rain and you don't want to go about 10 hours to some hole to find some drinkable water, when you do get some,
you gotta store it in such things.
About to show you guys my strength. Did you see it? It moved a little bit, but I moved it.
Pues la misma ropa que
¿compra?
Ella.
¿Compra? ¿Compra?
Sí, sí, estoy. Estamos mirando.
You want to buy from everybody. Get something from everybody if possible.
¿Compra?
I think my phone is too big, but I'll still take it.
It's a little purse.
Sí.
¿Cuánto
es? It's cute.
40.
40 pesos.
Okay. ¿Se compra?
Sí, es más grande para mi chica. Uno.
Toma, aquí tienes.
No tengo cambio.
Está bien, quédate con el doctor. Ostras, esos son los zapatos tradicionales, ¿no? Los huaraches.
Compra.
They're all wearing them. Oh, everybody wants to sell something. As you can see over here, we're about a month into the rainy season, but this is still completely dry. Maybe some water flew during a heavy night of rain. You can tell the ground here is a little bit more moist, but still maybe not enough for them to be able to plant everything. And then here, let me show you this part here. Here's their cemetery where they bury those that have passed away from the community. ¿Qué hora? ¿Qué hora?
A ver, no, cochinan.
¿Gochinan? ¿Qué significa?
Perro.
¿Ah? Perro. Ah, el perro es gochinan.
Cochi.
Cochi. Ok. ¿Ese es tu hermanito? ¿Tu sobrino? ¿Y cómo se llama?
Todavía no tiene nombre.
¿Todavía no tiene nombre?
Ah.
¿A qué edad le dan el nombre?
El domingo ya se lo puedo poner.
¿Perdón?
Domingo, poner nombre.
Ah. ¿Todavía no le ponen nombre?
No.
¿Y ustedes todos son de acá? ¿De San Ignacio?
Sí.
Está bien. Hola.
¿Están grabando?
¿Ah?
¿Están grabando?
Sí, estoy haciendo un video aquí para la familia. Digan hola. Cochi. Cochi. They're laughing at me. Se están riendo de mí. ¿Por qué? ¿Mi pronunciación es cómica? ¿Mi pronunciación, la forma que digo gochi? ¿Cochi?
Cochi.
Cochi. Cochi. Cochi. ¿Y cuántos años tiene el bebé?
9 meses.
Ah, ni siquiera un añito. Hola. ¿Qué hora? Ok. Lo dejo tranquilo. Que tengan un buen día, pues.
En los 1700s. Europeans came over here and they brought over their religion and converted the people over here to be Catholic. However, they respected what they believed in. And it is said that the Rarámuris used to pray to the sun or to the moon god whenever it rained or they had good crops that year or whatever. They'll give thanks that way. So
they respected that by living here kind of a sun and over here kind of a moon. To respect that.
This church is from the 1700s. As you can see, it has everything that any other Catholic church will have. You have all your stations here. What you're seeing behind me is the school for the Rarámuri people. So this is the only one. It is sponsored by the federal government, and basically since the majority of the Rarámuri people live very far, they cannot come daily to school. So what they do is they'll come here either on a Sunday afternoon at whatever time or Monday morning, and they stay over here until Friday when the last day of class is done. And their classes are taught in both their language, Rarámuri, and Spanish as well, to in case they don't speak Spanish. But the majority in this area, they'll speak some sort of Spanish or understand it due to, well, the tourism and the way they make money selling their handmade goods. But this is the old school over here. I'm gonna go over there and check out the store. This right here is the store here in the village. Now, the difference between this store and other stores is that the store was provided by the government, and the government put the price, which is lower than you'll find in the other store here for the locals. But you can also shop here if you like, and well, you get some goods like that, some canned stuff. Just in case you were wondering, permiso, perdón. In case you were wondering what they might use money for, yeah, most of them live off the land and that's how they do it. But there's certain things that they might not have, like the threads to be able to make their clothes, or maybe some coffee, or certain things that just don't grow at all in the region. And over time they've tasted and begun to like, well, this is where they get it. Eres jarami, pero hablas inglés, me dicen.
Sí, poco.
What can you say in English?
What you say? What?
Hello, how are you?
I'm fine,
You're fine?
I'm fine, I'm working here.
Working here?
Yeah.
With the stocking the refrigerator.
Yes.
And your name?
Antonio Lerma.
Antonio Lerma.
Yeah.
My name is Carlos, and a pleasure to meet you.
Carlos, where come from?
Venezuela.
Venezuela?
Yes.
Alright.
Yes. And you're local here from Aromari?
I'm here, yes. I was born here, and I was living here, and then I was in Juarez at times ago.
In Juarez?
Yes.
Okay. And you learned English in Juarez?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. All right, brother. Take care, man. Thank you.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Hello. ¿Qué hora?
Dale un chingo a ese güey.
Hola.
Hola.
¿Ustedes son de acá?
¿Dónde?
De aquí, de San Ignacio.
Sí, sí.
¿Les gusta jugar Grand Theft Auto?
Sí.
I can't lie.
Pistol hit, ¿no? Dice que te mataron.
Man, I'm a big fan of Grand Theft Auto. A mí también me gusta Grand Theft Auto mucho. What else? But they have another. Oh, Metal Slug. That's a classic. Oh, so you put a coin in there and then you can play. Well, this will be the city center, if we can say. Like I said, this is the largest community here. The rest of the Tahomari people are scattered all around deep into the valley. Well, you got the basketball court. That's the school right there. And I want to show you guys over there the Casa de Salud. Basically, the people here, they can be prone to certain diseases, mainly respiratory diseases in the winter. And then during the summer months, they'll get other diseases. And this is where they get treated for some of these diseases. That who knows if they've always been here? Who knows? The traditional way of giving birth for the people here is the women, they kind of hang like this pretty much, and the baby comes out like that. And what happens is that you get a lot of, well, the mortality rate is pretty high for both the baby and the women. So what they try to do here is pretty much, let me get out of the sun, pretty much just try to educate them and give them some nursing during the pregnancy, and then when they're ready to pop, take them over to Krill and give birth there, and well, the survival rate is a lot higher. So that's what we have here. It's closed now, and like I said, they live off the land. Looks like they're growing some corn there. And just overall, very peaceful vibes over here. Let's go around these rocks and see what we find. Kira. These are volcanic rocks around here.
You have a cochi there.
Word of the day, guys, cochi. You can see these beautiful rock formations everywhere here. Well, before these guys were converted to Catholics, they would pray or give thanks to these rocks for the rains or all that stuff, and they'll do dances and traditional parties, we can say. What happened here is the government decided to build them kind of like a little amphitheater here so that they can use it, but the truth is that it doesn't get used at all. The locals, they don't like it at all, and well, they just prefer the beautiful natural rocks that they have and to keep things very traditional. Except for the kids that were into Grand Theft Auto. Those guys are waiting for a PS5 to drop in soon. You could just imagine all the ceremonies hundreds of years ago that have taken place right here. People here worshiping these rocks, thanking them for the rain or a good crop, all right here, guys.
Quite beautiful, if you ask me. We're gonna climb to the top of the cliff and get the ultimate view.
I'm like being between excited and scared. Hey. I have to get to the middle and there. I'm not sure if I'm gonna fall.
You'll be all right. Hey, ¿cuál es tu nombre?
Rosa.
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 Y yo, Carlos.
Sí.
Yo, Sofía.
Ah, sí. A mí, la hija de mi prima se llama Sofía, la niña chiquita.
Oh, sí.
Que tiene rosas en las alas.
¿Y siempre subes aquí todos los días?
Todo el día.
¿Todo el día? ¿Cuántas veces al día?
No sé, no la he contado, pero siempre seguido subimos aquí.
Sí.
We have to come back this way after.
Yep. Uy.
Este pie, apoya este pie.
Este pie aquí.
Y el otro pie apoya aquí.
Don't worry, the fall down is not too bad at all. Ah, okay, no, pone su peso contra el lado de la piedra. Ah, okay, ya vi la técnica. Oh, man. Oh, what a... All right, we're almost getting to the view. Wow.
Aquí está bien.
What a view.
Wow.
Whoa. Have a look at this view, guys. Jeez Louise. Esta es tu parte favorita, Rosa.
Sí. Aquí no hace calor.
No hace calor. Alright, Rosa likes to live life on the edge. ¿Cómo vas a tan fa- Yeah, that was the most embarrassing moment of my life. You should have seen the mess I made of myself to get down from there. I don't know, Rosa just slid down as she's walking down the steps.
¿Y qué tienes
aquí, Rosa, para ver?
Pues era así, ella verlo si
dejaste. ¿Eso los haces tú?
No, yo no sé, yo no me ayudo a vender este.
Ok.
Yo casi no puedo hacer tesañez. Hay de chiquitos 50, hay de grandes también.
Ah, oh, me gustó esto.
Sí.
Ah, oh, sí, vamos a...
¿50?
Sí.
Estos son para la cabeza.
Sí, para cintura también.
Y para cinturón también. Ok. ¿Y esto los haces tú o...?
No. Lo hace mi cuñada también.
¿Tu cuñada?
Yo además ayudo a vender.
¿Y tú la ayudas?
Sí.
Todas hechas a manos acá.
Sí, ajá.
¿Y cuánto es que es?
50.
Okay.
De esos 70.
Aquí está 100 pesos. Estamos bien así. Muchas gracias, Rosa.
¿Y qué nos puedes decir en tu lengua natal? Dinos algo.
Gracias, que decir chirihueraba.
Chirihueraba.
Sí, gracias.
¿Y qué más? ¿Qué es la frase más común que dicen ustedes en su lengua?
Cuira quiere decir buenos días, así como tiene...
Sí, cuira.
Sí, ajá.
Buenos días.
Sí, buenos días. Reme, que es tortilla.
¿Y cómo se dice este paisaje es hermoso?
Semática, uy.
Semática, uy.
Sí,
Semática, uy.
Y gracias.
Chiriguéraba.
Chiriguéraba.
Sí, che, ¿cómo te llamas? Quiere decir, este, Chimiriba quiere decir, ¿cómo te llamas? Es una pregunta.
Ok. Sí. Y aquí, este, típicamente primero aprendes Jararamuri y después español,
sí.
¿O?
Ajá. Sí. Okay. Yo aprendí así, este, así, vendiendo en este, tres años, así, aprendí aquí a vender.
¿Aprendiste español vendiendo,
sí,
aquí?
Porque yo no fui cuando era chiquita de la escuela, de la escuela.
¿O no fuiste a la escuela? ¿Aprendiste, no, tú la, solita acá?
Sí, por la malita de la vista no fui a la escuela.
Ah, wow.
Sí.
Pero aprendiste tú sola aquí, sí, y ahora hablas español y te gusta conversar aquí con,
sí,
la gente.
Uh-huh.
Está muy bien, Rosita. Nos encanta que viniste con nosotros. Un placer conocerte.
Yo siempre subo para las personas aquí.
Sí.
Yo le ayudo a subir también personas.
Si, si tú quieres aprender una nueva palabra en francés,
sí,
soy de Francia.
Ah.
Y para decir hola, es bonjour.
Sí.
¿Quieres rata? Bonjour.
No. Bonjour.
Bonjour.
No, no.
Es más complicado.
Es un poco difícil.
Sí, difícil.
Sí. ¿Ese es tu caballo?
Sí.
¿Y lo usas para mover la madera, para...?
Sí, para las siembras también.
¿Las siembras, artesanías o cosas?
Sí.
Oh, wow. Hola. ¿Qué agua? ¿Qué hará? ¿Es mansito?
Sí.
¿Sí? Como que no le gusta. Sí, no, lo dejo mejor.
Present to you guys Elephant Rock.
If you have enough imagination, you can see the front of an elephant.
This lake is shaped like a horseshoe if you were to see it from above. 3 kilometers long, and well, you can see the drought that's been going on this year.
The camera won't pick it up, but you can see on the rocks the water levels are marked, and I mean, even here you can see that it should kind of be a bit higher there.
Times like this, I wish I will still be bringing my drone on my travels. Aquí está. Muchísimas gracias.
Igual.
Alrighty, guys. I got my hoodie. $5. I like it. Handmade. Now, I'm gonna wrap up the video here, guys. We're back in Creel, as you can see. Buenas. They're making more stuff by hand there. And here in Creel, it's very touristic. Let me show you.
Shops selling the same stuff, restaurants everywhere.
It's a little touristic heaven. So my personal recommendation is to get out of Creel. You can do it on your own, or there are some tours that will take you around. And if you're gonna purchase stuff, purchase directly from the people. That way they get the full percentage of the earnings, the profit.
And no, everything we saw was just amazing. Like, makes you want to travel more and discover more people's way of living, you know?
Exactly, you really get a different feel of life. Even though the villages we visited were nearby and they have been touched by the Western influence a bit. I mean, you saw we had the shop there, they were drinking Coca-Cola and whatnot and playing Grand Theft Auto. Unfortunate in my opinion, because I think their way of life is quite beautiful and something that every person... Oh, here they have more of them.
But again, these are shops.
I prefer to buy direct. And I lost my thought. Anybody that comes from a Western country, a city, or even a small town, and to see their way of life, how they live off the land with nothing else, is really something. Even though more than half of them in this area weren't, you still get the vibe of their way of life. And it's something incredible. One more thing to say. Omari means light feet. And they're really known for that. They basically, any marathon that they participate in, they win. They are known for their resistance running. They can run for miles. They can walk for miles. That's what they've been doing throughout their lives. living high up here in the mountains, the air is thinner. Your body just, at least if you're not used to it, you're just gonna have less oxygen in the blood and basically you're gonna get tired faster, but not the Jajomaris. They'll go on forever and ever and ever. And I have nothing else to say, guys.
10 peso burritos, what the heck? Sounds
too good to be true. That's gonna wrap up this video, guys. Hope you liked it. And if you're ever in town, I highly recommend coming by over here. Definitely. I don't make the videos with the high-end camera and the drone to show you all the beautiful sights, but let me tell you, they are some of the most beautiful sights I've ever seen, period. Incredible. Those valleys, top class, guys. All right, that's it.